It was mind-blowing and a very surreal experience. I think, you know, I'll always remember special moments that come along with that. You know, the moment that they announce that you are part of the Olympic team is a moment I'll never forget. When you're getting your wardrobe and your team jackets and you get to walk in opening ceremonies, you get a ring. There's so many things that happen along the way that make you feel so special and so part of the games. And it's a bit overwhelming. You know, you work your entire life to maybe someday go to the Olympics, and then to forever be called an Olympian still is shocking to me. Sometimes I have to pinch myself. It was just a very special moment. I was so young and I was so lucky that so many of the athletes, I think, sort of recognized that and were, you know, went out of their way to make me feel part of it. And so being so young, I almost think was an advantage, you know, to be able to meet people and feel part of that movement. You dream about this moment your entire life. You know, there's so many times I went to bed and thought about it and rehearsed it in my head if it were to ever happen. And it's better than you ever imagine. It is, again, just this very surreal moment that happens so quickly. And you're just trying to take it all in and process what happened, because if you think about it, for, you know, 15 years, you're training for a certain goal, you're training for one thing to happen, and it's never happening, and you're doubting it all along the way, and then in seconds, it happened. And it's just a very surreal moment. Everyone has fears and doubts, and I was one of those skaters that always doubted myself. I was never, you know, overly confident, and I always wish that I was, because that would have made it a lot easier and less stressful, but I wasn't. And then I realized after I finished that sometimes those nerves are good, and that sometimes some people perform better under extreme pressure. And I realized that I perform my best under extreme pressure. So there's something that gives you this sense of relief knowing that. So even now I work in live television, and I remember thinking, why did I pick another thing that is just difficult and has pressure? And I realize it's because I love it, and I also know that I work best under those types of circumstances. Every athlete probably has something very unique to themselves, and I think for me, the valuable lessons that I learned was hard work and that nothing comes easy. And I take that throughout my life. Now I know if something seems too easy, that means I'm not working hard enough and that the outcome won't be what I want it to be. But again, that's personal to me. But I would say that would be something that, you know, I lived firsthand. And the harder you work at something you love, the better the outcome will be.